had a little bit of a tire issue here on the trailer, my new trailer. This was a decent tire. And then look at those splits. And look at the inside here. Now what's happened is side of the sidewall got chewed up. All we had on this trailer, on my new trailer, were the two Kubotas. There's that structural bar. On my other trailer, this is in further, so it doesn't interfere with the fenders and tires at all. But as you can see, it's already been lowered one notch. The suspension's already been lowered one, but there's still some interference here. Well, as a solution, not rubbing on this center. This is just because the tire got taken out. Rubbing on here, that's what's taking it out. And of course, the tire starts flapping around inside and takes it. We were lucky we made it back here, back home, the home base. But yeah, this tire clearance, I think possibly when the tire goes down to one, that fender was rubbing. Of course, this has to all happen when it's raining out. Oh, there's not much space in there. Oh, this one's about to interfere as well. And these are 205 70 15s. I'm gonna see if I can change the actual tire size so they're all a little bit different. This one's a 205 70 15 as well, but this tire is just a scrap tire that we threw on here. See the weather cracks here, but it does the trick. These trailers are so hard on tires. Every time you turn, it always grinds off part of the tread on one. Just because you're dragging the axle all the time to make any kind of turn. So these seem to go through a lot of tires anyways. Nathan, what do you got to say? What do you got to say for yourself? What do you think of this?
Good to be back.
Good to be back, eh? Never a dull moment here at Moore Lawn Care. So you can see with the weight off, there's lots of clearance, but we still gotta take that tire off and grind it all off. Fun. So I was at my one property today, and I saw something dangling underneath the trailer. The brake line. I just kind of wedged it here so I could make it home, but yeah, it looks like it's been rubbing on the cement for quite some time. I don't know why that wasn't threaded inside the housing. Hmm.